really thrilled and excited. I really want to share that experience with you, how exactly it happened and all that. Wednesday we had the webinar. So Wednesday was a session, and you know, like it's for us, like when Grace Ma'am says something and all that, it's not that she's, you know, our academic director and all. Apart from that also, you know, like when she says something, it's like, yeah, we are going to do that. So with all those things, you know, I attended the session and it was like, it really looked very interesting. Okay, this drawing tool and all that. See, not everyone will be a good artist. And, you know, there'll be certain times when, you know, we have to go beyond, and now this online and all that, you know, even kids also will have a lot of expectation. At the same time, even parents also will have. So Wednesday was that, okay, I just attended. It really looked very interesting for me. And after that, you know, Thursday was, a session wherein I had a class wherein I had to teach them this body parts and all that. And when we give it off in the worksheets and all, no, really children, they find it difficult to draw. Okay. And definitely they will take parents' help. They will like, okay, parents also like, oh my God, okay, ma'am has given, you know, we have to make them write and all that. Then I thought, okay, let us not put that burden on parents' head. I thought I will just train them in my class. This was pre-planned. And I attended your webinar, and then after that, okay, I usually do homeworks. It's like, you know, we are all under Grace Ma'am's guidance and all that, and we do our homework. I usually put my daughter, my son, both of them to sleep, and after 10:30 or 11 is, you know, I sit for my work. I just said, and you know, it really took time for me, go to Google, download all those things, and you know, I made that as a favorite one. We have that option, right, the bookmark one. So I just, you know, kept all those things ready. And then after that, you know, it was really, I was also wondering whether it's going to work or not. I didn't know that. I just kept it. And I also kept plan B also. Plan A was, I'm going to use this tool. And plan B was that, okay, if that doesn't work, see, all these things, you know, sometimes it will be beyond our hands. It doesn't work also. What is the next thing? So plan B was, I had kept my book, pencil and all the drawing book and all that ready. And then after that, okay, when I started my session and all that, I started, you know, teaching, see, this is how you're going to do first this lines and all that. Then I used that tool and all that, and it was neatly projected. And students were also, they were really enjoying the drawing session. Students, though, it is like they enjoy, okay, drawing sessions and all that. So when I was just teaching that, you know, and I could really, you know, very quickly, I could do it on the board. And they were like, wow, ma'am, you are such a good artist. You draw so well. No, because I teach three different subjects. I'm into English department and science and social. So it was like, wow, ma'am, you also teach English, you also do drawing. They started praising me. Actually, the, you know, magic behind that was the tool. Okay, the magic tool. And you know, even parents were like, ma'am, good, ma'am, you taught even the drawing also. Because otherwise, you know, we are supposed to draw and we tell them you color and all that. But you literally taught them in the class. And this really made our work easy, is what parents after the session. Then, you know, when I was just doing that only, I couldn't control myself. When kids were, you know, so positively responding, I just randomly, you know, clicked few pictures and all that. And then later I just forwarded to Grace Ma'am. And this is what it all happened. And all thanks to, you know, the magic tool, which you really taught us. And
I would like to ask you a few questions to understand. I'm sure there are a lot of webinars happened for you from board, from the CBC board, as well as within the school, and maybe among the teachers you may be contacting in-house. So yeah. What was your thought process when a webinar like AI for Educators and Capacity Building was announced?
That was like initially, yeah, I thought even this is going to be just a normal one, because usually, you know, we attend other webinars wherein they talk about this thing, this is how it should be, you should upgrade yourself, you have to do that, you have to do this, all blah, 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 blah kind of thing. But actually, what are the tools that we require for our upgradation is what we see. Now during this pandemic, you know, we all educators, we have just, you know, taken one step ahead and we have, you know, completely switched over these things. And, you know, for this, it is not only we have learned the teams, we have learned presentations, we know how to, you know, do PowerPoint, all these things. Apart from that also, just a normal kind of webinar, just, you know, speaking on the topic, that doesn't really matter. Okay, something like this, you upgrade yourself. That is where, you know, like, yeah, we have to, you know, implement these things in our classroom. That idea was really very nice when I attended.
Wonderful, wonderful to hear. What were the children's reaction when they saw something like this tool to use?
Yeah, as I told you, the children were like, they were really interested. Once when we just post these worksheets and all, no, we just download the pictures from Google or any other source and we just put it across there. And, you know, a big question mark arises in parents' mind as well as in students' mind, like, how do we do that drawing and all those things? And you know, when we teachers only, when we teach them in this live sessions, when we take up the classes and all, when students only know, that shouldn't be a problem for them when they are writing their answers and all. So easily they can draw and at the same time, you know, answer the questions. So that is where, you know, they were really excited is what I, you know, found them.
Any tips, ma'am, as a company would like to understand, what do you think that we are doing that teachers feel that they should use this tool in this school?
Because when we are teaching, you know, many a times what happens are, if I talk about English subject, when we talk about literature and all, no, it will be like pictorial based, the textbook contents and all, and children will usually like, you know, when we have to grab the attention of students, something colorful you show them, definitely, you know, they will immediately look into that, they will start observing and all those things. And you know, like when we are teaching grammar, it is like entirely different. Grammar subject is something little dry, wherein, you know, we have to give them a lot of examples and all that. So here at that point we can definitely use, because you know, when we draw those things, you know, very quickly if it happens, see, this is what it is, this is Ria, she's a good girl, and we have to insert pronoun over there, and we can do in that way. So in grammar too, it is like very useful for English. And when it comes to science and all that, no, like not all teachers will be very good at drawing. Okay, there are teachers like me who are not that very good at drawing. So probably this tool will really help there. And when we have to teach the social science and all, no, using this map and all that, since I take all these three subjects, I can very easily connect and tell you like these are the areas wherein we can use and all that. So social too, we draw this map and all those things, and that area we can definitely use is what I feel. This is what I have explored till date.
Yeah. I would love to probably hear more as you start exploring more on the tools and start taking experiences in the classes.
We'll really have only 30 minutes of our session. Mm-hmm. And this is very quick as well.
So as I understand that the session on webinar on AI for Educators Capacity Building was worth the time of yours.
Absolutely. It was really, really, you know, a very useful tool. And, you know, that was like, you know, a kind of boon for me, because Thursday I had planned that I'm going to do this. And Wednesday I had this webinar and I attended the session and all that. And I said, okay, let me start implementing it. You know, we should always, you know, as educators and all that, we should think out of the box, you know, to reach children, you know, every time use that textbook, take a chalk paste teach, or use that, see, this is PPT. That PPT level is also gone now.
Thanks for time, wonderful. Sharing your experience on usage of AI tool in the classrooms and for engagement and learning purpose, especially when you have only 30 minutes of time on an online session.